New at 6, disturbing new photos of the home in Crystal Lake where 5-year-old AJ Freund lived and died, allegedly at the hands of his parents.
And tonight, new court documents and photographs are giving us a closer look at his life and the investigation into his death. WGN's Tom Negevin is here with details. Tom.
Yeah, Micah and Joe, the pictures support what we've already learned, what police and prosecutors have told us. And tonight, we also have some family photos that may help us understand how a case like this could so badly fall through the cracks. The photos, obtained by WGN News under the Freedom of Information Act, give us our first look inside the family's Crystal Lake home. They go back to 2013. The house appears filthy, in complete disarray, which aligns with reports from police around that time, the first written just 4 days after the boy was born, with opiates and benzodiazepines in his blood. AJ was taken from his mother then by the Department of Children and Family Services and returned 18 months later. His death has badly shaken the people of Crystal Lake. Police reports document 17 visits to the Freund home over the last 5 years, describing deplorable living conditions, evidence of drug use by his parents, and concern for the well-being of the children. As we've already reported, McHenry County prosecutors say AJ's mother, Joanne Cunningham, had video on her phone more than a month before his death showing bruises on his face and body. His father, Andrew Freund Sr., told investigators she caused those injuries. The newly released documents also show he said AJ was put into a cold shower on or about April 15th as punishment for lying about soiled underwear, beaten, and sent to bed. Investigators say Joanne Cunningham later did a Google search for child CPR, that his father took the boy's body to the basement and stored him in a tote, then went shopping for duct tape, plastic gloves, air freshener, and bleach. The day before AJ was reported missing, investigators say his father put his body in the trunk of his car, drove to this remote area in Woodstock, and placed AJ in a shallow grave, covered him with straw, and left. It's not just a horrifying story, but one with a gut-wrenching paradox. These photos, provided to us by AJ's older brother, offering a much different perspective, a life that clearly had many happy moments. Images of a playful little boy enjoying the loving embrace of his family. And it's that disconnect that may be at the heart of the DCFS failure to intervene as aggressively as critics now say it should have. AJ's parents remain behind bars, charged with his murder, and there is a public visitation for AJ Freund in Crystal Lake tomorrow, 1 to 8 p.m. at Davenport Funeral Home. And we have an advisory from police just out on that. They're preparing for heavy traffic. A shuttle bus and overflow parking are being arranged for those who plan to pay their respects. And there are a lot of those people remembering AJ tonight and tomorrow.
All right. Thank you, Tom.